गुड मॉर्निंग। यस्टरडे वी आर इन द प्रीवियस पीरियड वी आर सॉल्विंग द प्रॉब्लम फॉर द कोरिलेशन कोएफिशिएंट विद द मेथड ऑफ कार्ल पियर्सन्स कोरिलेशन कोएफिशिएंट बाय डायरेक्ट मेथड। टुडे लेट अस टेक अप द सेम एग्जांपल विद द डिफरेंट मेथड दैट इज शॉर्टकट मेथड। In the shortcut method, the values will be reduced. In the sense, whenever you have a mass of values or very big values, very difficult to or tedious to compute the calculations, in such cases, we use the shortcut method. So in the shortcut method, we use first take up the average of the variables. Here two variables are there, x variable and y variable. Consider this example. See, same example yesterday what you have done in the direct method. The x values are 65, 66, 67, etc. Y values 67, 68, 65, etc. These are the values. Now the next column is we have to convert these x and y variables with different values. In the sense, we have to convert this to simpler number. Simple, that is by taking the deviation by its average. So average is already we have computed in the previous class. The variable x, the mean of variable x is 68. Similarly, average of y variable is equal to 69. Now, the first column is x variable, second column is y variable, and the third column is the difference between xi minus x bar equal to u. So, we are changing the origin, we are shifting the origin by change of scale. See, u equal to xi minus x bar means xi means different values of x. What are the different values of x? 65, 66, 67, etc. What is the average? Average is 68. So the first value is 65. 65 minus 68 gives you minus 3. 66 minus 68 gives you minus 2. 67 minus 68 gives you minus 1. Similarly, other values will be calculated. The next column is the v equal to yi minus y bar. As the here also, the variables of y are 67, 68, 65, 68, 72, etc. The average is 69. So yi minus y bar is y1 minus y bar, that is equal to 67 minus 69, that gives you minus 2. 68 minus 69, that gives you minus 1. And 65 minus 69, that gives you minus 4, etc. Next column is the u square. U square is the deviation what you have taken for the xi minus x bar, square of the deviations of x variables taken by mean, that is u square. That means xi minus x bar the whole square. Xi minus x bar you have already calculated here, that is minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, etc. Square of that values, that is simple. Similarly, v square equal to the variable y, v square equal to the deviation of y variables, that is yi minus y bar the whole square. The last column is uv. Uv is product of u into v. U is here, v is here. So this is the all about the table. Now take the total of that. The sum of u is always 0, sum of v is always 0. So that is the property of the average. If you have different values of 0 other than 0, if you have got the value other than 0, then it means that your calculation is wrong. Always it should be the sum, the algebraic sum of deviations taken from mean is always zero. That is the property of average. So, sum of u is equal to 0, sum of v is equal to 0, u square, sum of u square equal to, in this case is 36, sum of u square is equal to 44, and the product of uv, the sum of that is 24. Now, coming to the example. See, the calculation part. That is, what is the covariance between between x and y? Before that, let us, what is the formula for correlation coefficient? Carl Pearson's correlation coefficient is defined by covariance between x and y divided by standard deviation of x into standard deviation of y. Now, what is the covariance between u and v? Here, u and v, because we have the change of origin, in the sense x values are changed to u values and y values are changed to v values. Therefore, here the correlation coefficient equal to r equal to covariance between u and v and standard deviation of u and standard deviation of v. U bar and v bar you have to calculate. Now u bar equal to 1 upon n, that is 0, and covariance between u and v equal to 1 upon n into sum of u v minus u bar v bar. Sum of u bar v bar, that is u bar into v bar, that is equal to 1 upon 8 into 24 minus 0 into 0, that is equal to 3. Now, standard deviation of u, or u square, sigma u square is the variance. Square root of that equal to standard deviation, of course. So, sigma u square equal to 1 upon n into sum of u square minus u bar the whole square. That is equal to 1 upon n, n is 8, sum of u square is 36 minus u bar is 0. Therefore, square of the u bar is again 0, the answer is 4.5. Similarly, sigma v square is the actually standard deviation of the variable v. So, sigma squared is the variance, sigma v is the standard deviation for the variable v. So, sigma v squared, that is equal to variance of v, equal to 1 upon n into sum of v squared minus v bar the whole square. That is equal to 1 upon 8, n is 8 here, 1 upon 8 into 44 minus v squared is again 0, because sum of average, sum of v bar is equal to 0. Now, coming to the correlation coefficient equal to the covariance between u and v. Covariance between u and v is the 3 and positive square root of the standard deviation of u into standard deviation of v. Standard deviation is equal to root of the variance. Variance you have already calculated, sigma u square and sigma v square. That is the variance. The square root of the variance is the standard deviation. So, positive square root of 4.5 into 5.5. That gives you the answer is 6.6. This is the answer what you have got as earlier. So, same answer you have got. So, only the method is changed. You have, in the previous method, we have used the direct method. We have used the shortcut method or deviation method. The next, let us consider the example number 2. Example is like this. Calculate Carl Pearson's correlation coefficient between expenditure on advertising and sales from the data given below. The data is like this. First row is advertising expenses, second is sales. See, 89, 65, 60, etc. The sales is in terms of lakhs of rupees, 47, 53, 68, etc. Now, as earlier, you have to again take it into columns, different columns. First column is the x variable, second column is the y variable. Next is, I have taken dx here. Dx is, in the previous example, I have taken u. Here also the same dx. Dx is nothing but deviation in the value of x. You can take in this manner also. That is how I have taken here. Two ways are there. You can take u or you can take dx, whatever. So, dx means deviation of x. So the deviation of x equal to x psi minus x bar. X bar equal to sum of x divided by n. So here x values are first column, so y values are second column. The first column is the sum of x is the all values here 650 here 650 and sum of y equal to 660. So the mean of x, the x bar equal to sum of x divided by n, that is equal to 650 divided by n. N is number of values. Here values are 10. So 650 divided by 10 gives you 65. Similarly, y bar is again sum of y values divided by the number of observations. That is, sum of y is 660 and the number of observations equal to 10. So the answer is 66. Now, by using these averages, you can come to the next column, that is dx equal to xi minus x bar. Xi minus x bar, as earlier, x bar is 65, so 39 minus 65 gives you minus 26, 65 minus 65 is 0, 62 minus 65 gives you minus 3, etc. All other values. Similarly, in the fourth column, you take the deviation of y, that is dy. Dy equal to yi minus y bar. Y bar means mean of the y values, that is mean of y equal to have already calculated, that is 66. Now, so that becomes yi minus y bar equal to yi minus 66. The first value of y is variable y equal to 47. So 47 minus 66 gives you minus 19. And similarly, 53 minus 66 gives you minus 13. Similarly, the other values you have to compute. Other values 58 minus 66, 86 minus 66, 62 minus 66, etc., etc., etc. All other values can compute in the similar way. The next column, as earlier, in the example, previous example, you have taken u squared, v squared. Now you have to take similarly the dx squared and dy squared and product of dx, dy. Dx squared is the square of the values of deviation taken from mean of x variables. Similarly, other y values and the product of dx and dy. Next, we have to take the all sum of all values. See, as earlier, here also deviation taken from mean is it should be 0. So, sum of dx should be 0 and sum of dy is also 0. Then dx squared, sum of dx squared compute, that is 5398. Similarly, dy squared equal to 2224 and the product of dx dy, the sum of that value is equal to 2704. Now come to the calculation. So Carl Pearson's correlation coefficient is given by r of x equal to denoted by r x y or simply r equal to covariance between x and y divided by standard deviation of x into standard deviation of y. But you have used here the different formula. See, different formula since in the different way. You see here, that is equal to covariance between x and y equal to sum of dx into dy. In the sense, the sum of the product of dx and dy. You have already computed in the third column dx, in the fourth column dy. Take product here, the last column you have taken the dx into dy. So take the sum of that. Sum of is 2704. That is the sum of dx into dy. Square root of sum of dx squared into dy squared. Dx is the deviation of x values from its mean. Similarly, dy squared is the square of the sum square of the values of y taken from its mean. So correlation coefficient r equal to 2704 divided by positive square root of 5398 into 2224. That gives you, if you compute this, simplify this, you get 0.7804. This is the other way, deviation method. However, these formula, both are the same formula. Whatever formula you can use, both are the same. Whichever is easy for you, you can use that in the examination. This is all about the this example. Let us stop here. In the next class, we have continue with the Spearman's rank correlation coefficient, that can be See you in the next class. Thank you.